In today's video, we are talking about extra heart sounds, S3 and S4 in particular. We're going to start with a quick review of S1 and S2, and maybe get a little saucy today, and I'll give you a real fun mnemonic, I think it's fun, to help you remember how S3 and S4 are different. We're going to take care of that right after this. Welcome back. My name is Tammy, and this is Nurse Minder, and on this channel, we do everything nursing. So if you're new here, consider subscribing below so that you get the next video when it's released. So let's first get started with a quick review of what S1 and S2 sound like and where they're originating. S1 is our lub, S2 is our dub. So S1 involves the tricuspid and mitral or bicuspid as it's known. Those valves are closing, causing a snap, and that's our S1 sound. This coincides with systole and coincides with that pulse. So you can find S1 by palpating a pulse and auscultating. S2 is the dub. It is when our pulmonic and aortic valves close after, and is the onset of diastole. Sorry, not after, it is the onset of diastole. What I didn't talk about in our first video is the chordae tendinae. So I've drawn those in today because the chordae tendinae have a role to play in those extra heart sounds, and we'll get into that shortly. But essentially what those are, they're fibrous cartilage that holds on to those flaps of the valves to prevent them from hyperextending, if you will. So as the flap opens, the chordae tendinae would relax, and then when they close, they're tense and they're at their longest, so it kind of prevents them from going too far back and into the atria themselves. We'll begin our discussion looking at the flow of blood as those valves are opening and closing. So we're actually going to start with S1. We have our AV valves closed, so that's our mitral and tricuspid, and our semilunar is open. So you'll see here that the blood is going from the ventricles. We have contraction of the ventricles, and blood is being ejected through the semilunar valves so that it can go out to the pulmonary system for oxygenation, or to the body to deliver nutrients. AV closes, there's our lub, SL is open. When we are finished with the blood ejecting from the ventricles, both the SL and the AV node will be closed for a very brief time, but the sound we're hearing at S2 is in fact the semilunar valves closing. That's the aortic and pulmonic. During the isometric relaxation phase, because there's no valves for the superior vena cava to drain into the right atrium, and there's no valves preventing blood coming through the pulmonary artery into the left atria, blood just naturally will flow into there. Now, as the pressure increases, that will force our AV valves to open, and blood will be ejected, as there's an active contraction happening here at the same time, into the ventricles. That eventually slows as the atria start to empty its contents and the ventricles fill up. Then we start to get a slow diastole, so the semilunar valves are still closed. AV valve is still open. As those ventricles start to fill up, the flow will start to slow down. And there's actually a normal physiological thing that happens here, and it's called atrial kick. And that's kind of like when those atria, they contract, and then they just give one more oomph, so that the last little bit of blood can be squeezed out of the atria into the ventricles, maximizing that ventricular contraction so we get the most blood ejected out into the body. Now, interesting enough, both of our extra heart sounds, S3 and S4, occur during diastole. We're going to talk about S3 first. In ventricular gallop, what we are hearing is a tensing of that chordae tendinae. And there's a few reasons we might have that. Fluid overload, congestive heart failure, my ventricle is an ineffective pump, and I'm not completely evacuating all that blood with each ejection. So I have a larger pool of blood sitting here. In addition, I've got a whole lot of blood coming in. I'm just not able to take it all. So these chordae tendinae
are tensing up and they're causing kind of a tap, a third sound. So that's my chordae tendinae. Now, to give you a mnemonic to help you remember this, there's a few out there. You may have heard of Tennessee, 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 Tennessee. But that one kind of confuses people sometimes. This one's a little bit easier. Fuck, you're screwed. Fuck, you're screwed. Fuck, you're screwed. Another way to remember this is lub dub ta. Lub dub ta. Lub dub ta. Fuck, you're screwed. Fuck, you're screwed. Lub dub ta. Lub dub ta. In S4, also known as the atrial gallop, the AV valves are still open. As I said, these are both in diastole, which means filling. So when we look at the ventricles for an S4, we see that they're resistant. They're really not wanting to stretch and accept. So we have a limited amount of volume of blood that we can take in there. This is common with hypertension and hypertrophy. But the atria still have all of this blood to deliver. And so it's going to get a little bit more forceful, and it's going to insist that the heart take more blood than it thinks it's capable of taking. And so what we end up having is this extra atrial kick almost. Like it's kicking harder, and we get this S4 happening just before those AV valves close. Now the way we remember this one is, well, fuck you. Well, fuck you. In this case, the non-compliant ventricles are what's causing the vibration and causing that S4 heart sound. When we come back to the heart, we can see, let's just get rid of our S3 and S4 for a minute. Love dub, love dub, love dub. AV valves closing, causing the love sound. Semilunar valves opening, allowing blood to eject. Semilunar valves and AV valves are closed here at the same time, but the sound we're hearing is the semilunar valves closing, dub. Now the S4 and the S3, sorry, the S3 is here. The S3, I've got a heart that's too full of fluid, it doesn't want to take very much. The chordae tendinae are kind of startled and they tense up. Tendinae causes my S3. And so then we get, fuck, you're screwed. Fuck, you're screwed. And I'll put S4 in orange here just to differentiate that. S4, wow. You. And so when you're listening to this heart sound, remember love dub, love dub, love dub, love dub ta, love dub ta, love dub ta, la love dub, la love dub, la love dub. But if that doesn't help you, you can always rely on the old standby, fuck, you're screwed. Or, well, fuck you. So when you're auscultating next time and the heart's telling you to fuck, you're screwed, or the heart saying, well, fuck you, you know you've got yourself an S3 or an S4. Best place to listen for these is over the mitral valve, and so that's that mid-clavicular fifth intercostal space. And if you have your patient roll onto their left side, you'll have even a better chance of catching that. And don't forget, for murmurs and extra heart sounds, we want to use our stethoscope lightly. If you press too hard, you can actually occlude that extra heart sound, and you're going to miss it altogether. And who wants to miss the heart telling you off? Not me. Don't forget to subscribe. Just hit that subscribe button below and you'll get the next video when it's released. Until next time, get that stethoscope out, practice your auscultation, and make it a great day.